Somebody once said, if you want to change the world, start out by making your bed. I think the point that we're trying to make is this. If you want to change the world, start with what's right in front of you right now. You see, the truth of the matter is that on our own, no one person can change the entire world. It's simply too big. But what we can help to change is what God has put in front of us right now. So how do we go about changing the world for God? Well, it's simple. We do it the way Jesus did, through one intentional act of love and kindness at a time. You see, love and kindness comes from a desire to bless and benefit other human beings. I mean, after all, God Himself lives to bless and benefit us, long before He ever lives to bless and benefit Himself. We see this in the life of Jesus. Before He ever preached a sermon, or told a parable, or He asked people to follow Him, before any of that, the first thing Jesus did was to change lives around Him through acts of love and kindness. Here was God on earth, and His motto was, I didn't come here looking to be served, but to serve. In other words, Jesus didn't come to earth looking for a blessing. He changed people's lives by being that blessing. Something I personally try to teach is that people will go where their needs can be met. You don't go to the plumber if you have a toothache, and you don't go to the dentist if you have your eyesight poor. So where do you go if you're lonely, hurting, discouraged, brokenhearted, and in need of help? You see, right in front of you is a world filled with people, and those people, well, they have needs. And the truth of the matter is, people are going to go to places where those needs can be met. This right here is the greatest opportunity for the church to spread the gospel Jesus' way through helping one person at a time. You see, people can argue with your doctrine. Well, they can argue with you about the Sabbath or what happens when you die or just about anything you believe. But what they can't argue with, what they won't refuse, is love. Acts of love and kindness is how we change the world because it allows us to show the world what God is really like. Ellen White put it this way in Christ Object Lessons, page 415. The last rays of merciful light, the last message of mercy to be given to the world is a revelation of His character of love. So how do we spread this message? Through one intentional act of love and kindness at a time. That's how we change the world for God. Again, that was our nugget for today. Please have a look at your lesson. Spread the love. I'll see you tomorrow.